first Chumash people were created on Santa Cruz Island. They were made from the seeds of a magic plant by the earth goddess, whose name was Hutash. Hutash was married to the sky snake, the Milky Way. He could make lightning bolts with his tongue. One day, he decided to make a gift to the Chumash people. He sent down a bolt of lightning and started a fire. After this, people kept fires burning so that they could keep warm and so that they could cook their food. In those days, the condor was a white bird, but the condor was very curious about the fire he saw burning in the Chumash village. He wanted to find out what it was, so he flew very low over the fire to get a better look. But he flew too close. He got his feathers scorched. They turned black. So now the condor is a black bird with just a little white left under the wings where they didn't get burned. After Sky Snake gave them fire, the Chumash people lived more comfortably. More people were born each year, and their villages got bigger and bigger. Santa Cruz Island was getting crowded, and the noise the people made was starting to annoy Hutash. It kept her awake at night, so finally, she decided that some of the Chumash would have to move off the island. It kept her awake at night. So, finally, she decided that some of the Chumash would have to move off the island. They would have to go to the mainland. Finally, Hutash had the idea of making a bridge out of a rainbow. She made a very long, very high rainbow, which stretched from the tallest mountain on Santa Cruz Island all the way to the tall, bony mountains in the Santa Monica Mountains. Hutash told the people to go across the Rainbow Bridge and fill the whole world with people. So the Chumash people started to go across the bridge. Some of them got across safely, but some people made the mistake of looking down. It was a long way down to the water, and the fog was swirling around. They got so dizzy that some of them fell off the rainbow bridge, down, down through the fog, into the ocean. Hutash felt very badly about this, because she had told them to cross the bridge. She didn't want them to drown. Instead, she turned them into dolphins. So the Chumash always said that dolphins were their brothers.
We just want to talk today about Satwewo and some of our Chumash culture.
I'm Thomas Blackburn. I'm an anthropologist at Cal Poly Pomona, and most of my professional career has been devoted to the reconstruction of Chumash culture and working with people like Charlie Cook to help them recover some aspects of that culture. And I guess that's what we're going to talk about today. It's interesting. I would be curious to get your reaction to the statement we used to hear a few years ago that the Chumash are dead, are extinct. There are no more Chumash.
1975, they had determined in Ventura County there's no more Chumash around. And there were some still remaining in Santa Barbara County, but they forgot to include the other counties like Santa Barbara and San Luis Obispo and Kern County and Los Angeles County. Now, it's pretty hard to be extinct when there's about 6,000 people can trace back their ancestry to the Chumash people.
Right. To me, one of the really emotional rewards of my own research is seeing it being used by people like yourself and other Native American descendants to recover some of what has been was lost or was feared to be lost for so long. And I find that very, very satisfying. Right here in Southern California, that people began to associate rock art and some of the other objects made by people like the Chumash and Gabrielino, the Southern California people, and began to suddenly realize that many of these sites had an astronomical association or astronomical alignments. And so forth. My friend Travis Hudson at Santa Barbara Museum of Natural History, for example, used some of my own research. I my dissertation, as you know, was published as December's Child. It's a collection of Chumash stories from collected by Harrington from people like Fernando Lobato and so on, myths and folk tales. And my friend Travis Hudson realized that many of these stories, of course, talk about important mythological beings in the upper world, like the sun and so on. And Travis began to be curious whether, as to whether some of the rock art might be associated with this. And they discovered an important rock art site up in the Santa Barbara backcountry, Condor Cave, where at some point a round hole had been dug through the wall of the cave, and at the time of the winter solstice, the sun rose on the horizon, and a beam of light came over the top of a point of rock and shone right into the cave onto this particular rock art panel. And Travis and others began to really investigate this. But it's interesting because it sort of started here, but now they're discovering all over the world that Native peoples have, unlike, we're so used to living in houses and we drive places, we never look at the sky, we never really look at our environment very much. But people like the Chumash and others, maybe Americans, lived in their environment. They were very much aware of their environment, and that included the movement of stars and planets, where the sun rose and set on the horizon, so many things about the environment. And we are just beginning to discover the tremendous body of knowledge that these people had, very sophisticated knowledge about the environment. And but certainly the rock art still remains very enigmatic. The Chumash rock art is some of the most complex rock art ever made anywhere in the world.
Kimayo, 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 weleyo, kimayo, kimayo, weleyo, kimayo, kimayo, weleyo, kimayo, 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 weleyo, kimayo, 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 weleyo, kimayo, kimayo, weleyo.
We have the remnants of Indian musics that we can still find today, early recordings, and we can compare those with these flutes and with the holes that are on them to see if the melodies can still be played in that way, or if they've been slightly altered, if the melodies have slightly evolved.